Thank you very much. Good afternoon to all of you. It's really a pleasure to be here with you today. I will share my slides so you can see also what I will talk about. But the topic is quite ambitious because it's about the future of transport and mobility, and the overall title of the conference is related to the transport and mobility towards the 2050. I will provide the perspective of the rail research innovation that is quite particular because I think all of you would like to see and to know already now how it will look like rail in 2050. And how this is driven? Well, it's driven by the European Commission Europe Green Deal, clearly the proposal of President von der Leyen, and more specifically has been developed last year, the European proposal of the sustainable and smart mobility strategy of the European Commission. And what it is about? Well, it's about reaching a major reduction of gas emissions for transport up to 90%. And we believe that rail is the key mobility and transport solution that will be capable to address such type of reduction. How? On two main areas. The first one is rethinking the way we are operating rail and the way we are looking at interacting with other modes of transport. And the second is addressing some greening of the rail itself, although rail is the most sustainable mode of transport that we have in the European Union. How we can achieve this type of transformation? Such type of transformation happen in addressing the technological and operational barrier that today are limiting the performance of the rail system. So in terms of capacity increase, in terms of operational reliability, in terms of increased punctuality, and one of the other key elements is the overall life cycle cost, because rail should be competitive as the other modes of transport will be on the ground, on the air, or the shipping. How we have realized this? Well, the Shift to Rail program is working around five innovation specific activities. The first one is related to the cost efficient and reliable trains. As you can see from this chart, you can see all the different areas into which Shift to Rail Research Innovation has been working with its partners, large suppliers, small, medium enterprises, operator, infrastructure manager, the scientific community, startups. Clearly, with the funding of the European Union, it's a program that has the value of 1 billion euro and is entering now the last phases of its activities. So on the new cost efficient and reliable trains, you can see we are dealing with all the subsystem, would be for traction system, would be for braking system, air conditioning, HVAC, modularity of the materials, but also the brain of the train itself, the train control and monitoring system. So we are looking at how to transform rail from the vehicle point of view, if you have from this perspective. The second major area is the intelligence of the system. So the what is command control signaling, but especially the evolution towards automated train operations and or autonomous train operation. In any case, introducing digitalization and automation. The current Shift to Rail program has contributed to develop the specification for the TSI 2022 package, introducing GO2. We have done tests in UK and Switzerland. Tests are using our specification ongoing in Germany and in the Netherlands. The idea is to create more opportunity to improve the performance of the rail system in terms of also energy efficiency. GO2 can contribute to reduce 30% of consumption in certain type of operational model in the rail system. But clearly, we are also working to the evolution towards the full driverless solution, or to be ready to go towards a driverless solution. And this is a partly will be done in the current program and partly will be done in the future program that we start soon. But have you, I think, already seen a concept like virtual coupling? And we have an example that was shown in InnoTrans 2018, the concept of moving block, and the key enabler of the 5G technologies of new telecommunication that will allow train-to-train and train-to-ground communication, especially combined with automation in train operations. And finally, satellite positioning as one of the key elements to reduce the cost of the trackside infrastructure, improving the information available about train positioning. The third area of activity is related to the infrastructure. Infrastructure still constitutes one of the major costs in terms of maintenance and future of rail. So we need to be sure that we create, in order to create a competitive rail system, in order to transform the rail system, and we are we need to work on, we have been working on intelligent asset management, but also on energy functions and switches and crossings. So we have really worked on the full or large part of the infrastructure spectrum, introducing and targeting in particular the availability of the rail infrastructure to increase the punctuality, to increase the performance and reliability of the rail system, but also to reduce the life cycle cost. And we have a few demonstrations we've shown also at InnoTrans 2022 next year. One of the key areas of operation is clearly the logistic and freight, is the work that is done in order to break down the barriers related to rail cargo. One of the key targets of the European Sustainable Smart Mobility Strategy is increasing 50% rail transport by 2030 and doubling it by 2050. This can happen if we go through a different barrier, as you can see also in this slide, and address all the shortcomings that have been identified. And it's really going through introduction of combination of technological, operational, and digital solution that can reach this. And require also the capacity to bring, involve the staff that is today involved in such type of operation. In particular, one of the flagship projects we have is the European Duct Delivery Program that has brought up a couple of weeks ago the choice for one European digital automatic coupler solution that results from the work also done in Shift to Rail, but not only, building upon the investment done by the Ministry of Transport of Germany, funding the DAC for Europe program, the winter test done in IP5 in this work package, as well as other work that was done outside Shift to Rail. Bringing together the sector has been the real success story that helped us to advance so fast in the European Duct Delivery Program. Another key area that is fundamental linking also with the freight, but with a different perspective, because the rail cargo at the end is serving the logistic value chain. So all the activity we do on the passenger in terms of new concept of vehicle and new concept of automation are complementing also by the work we have done on the ticketing services and the service to passenger, covering all the type of services like planning, shopping, ticketing, navigating, after sale, addressing the issue during the journeys via an interoperability framework that allows today, tested today in different four towns ongoing, connecting the different service provider that we have, not only a rail, but making connection also with aviation, or maybe new concept of transportation like electric bikes and so on and so on. And finally, we have how we bring all this together. We consider all these, and this is the major evolution that happened in Shift to Rail during the last year, is to move from fragmentation that happened before Shift to Rail, to move from the technological fragmentation to operational fragmentation, to look at rail as a European system of system, into which at the end we don't want only to harmonize, we want to reach a one European single network. This is exactly the thing we need to see by 2050. The transport and logistics of 2050 should be building upon the one single European rail network. And this European network is the result of bringing together the 27 network of the European Union, ensuring the connection with the border countries that we have. At the end, is what does it mean? A system is bringing together the operation, the infrastructure, the assets, the rolling stock, but at the center of all this is to provide services to people and passengers. And let me go to, you can also monitor the progress of Shift to Rail in the different indicator, but let me go rapidly to what you can expect afterwards. Afterwards, at the end of this year, a new program, Europe's Rail, will start, and the objective of this program is really to deliver a major transformation of the system with via three main areas. integrated European network, interfacing also with the urban, and targeting the objective of the European Commission to support the objective of the European Commission in terms of two-time service of high speed by 2030 and three-time by 2050, deliver a multimodality as integration of the services, and especially the rail industry competitiveness. And this is what we can expect to see also in terms of governance. We are not looking anymore at the only the pure research innovation, but we will be doing research innovation in a fully integrated system, governing system, including the system approach, the research innovation approach, but also the coordination and deployment of the different activities. What you will see by 2050 are new services provided by rail, optimized operation that are rethought in rail, and a new concept to innovative assets. Working together as a sector, supply industry, rail operator, infrastructure manager, scientific community, startup, SME, all the European member states, we are able to change the way rail is operated by 2050. This is really where we are investing substantially, tackling down the barriers that are today limiting the performance of the rail system. At the end, we come back to the beginning. At the end, we want to have achieve all these objectives that are corresponding to the needs of the people in Europe, connecting region, connecting different operations, and ensuring that the staff working today in rail is the key actor of this type of transformation. Thank you very much.
Carlo, grazie mille. I just, you know, was listening and then looking. It seems that you are building like an internet for railway, a new internet or something. It's incredible. So I don't know. Best of luck and of course a lot of patience. The only question, and I just saw the audience and asking, when it can happen in reality.
In reality, it happens every single day because we are working with the long-term perspective. But we see pieces of technology every single day entering the system. So, and I know it's not visible to the clients, it's not visible to the logistic value chain. But this is actually the approach we want to ensure is to, for example, GAO2, so the Grade Automation 2, will be part of the package of TSI 2022. This means that as from 2023, you can introduce automation GO2 in all the operational system in rail. While our target will remain to reach GO4 most probably, and this will take more time. The idea is to take the quick wins, the advantages that we have today from technologies, and bring them in the rail system. Yes, we can also build a new infrastructure. We will need new infrastructure. We need to fill the gaps. We need to connect all the capitals. But we think that digitalization automation is really a powerful instrument to accelerate the services to be provided to European citizens.